Just before midday, on the 25th of April, a 7.8 magnitude earthquake hit the center of Nepal. Within minutes, over 130,000 homes collapsed, and 85,000 others were damaged. By the end of May, the toll of the earthquake and its aftershocks was over 8,500 dead and 14,000 wounded. Victims were as much in densely populated cities such as Kathmandu and Pokhara as in remote rural areas. Several days after the quake, MSF deployed a reconnaissance team traveling by helicopter to locate the areas most in need, notably in Gorkha district, the epicenter.
Small mountain villages have been flattened and even larger towns are extremely difficult to get to. Some are accessible only by helicopter and it can take 7 hours to walk to others. The Ministry of Health and MSF decided it would be preferable to assist people who need our help in more remote locations rather than in the big towns.
MSF teams established their zone for intervention around the town of Arugat in Gorkha. A mountainous region, the inhabitants were in need of somewhere to take cover and essential items, so the teams began distributing shelters and blankets. The health center here was flattened. While awaiting the field hospital that needs to be assembled, the teams deal with the most urgent cases under this tarpaulin. Their resources are wholly inadequate.
This facility here is replacing the health center that was destroyed in the earthquake and which provides health care to the 10,000 inhabitants living here in Arugat, as well as the 40,000 people in the smaller, inaccessible villages in the surrounding health district. To give you an idea of the healthcare services available since the earthquake, this area here is where women give birth. A woman was here yesterday. It took her more than 3 hours to give birth, and she was surrounded by loads of people. It was rather strange, but all went well in the end. She had a little boy.
After many hours by road from Kathmandu, the inflatable hospital MSF sent over from Bordeaux arrived in Arugat. While the logistics team set it up, the surgical team provided support to Bhaktapur Hospital on the outskirts of the capital.
In this afternoon, we had 5 cases of surgery and some cases of soft tissue injuries, burns, and so the last case was so terrible because inside of the wound, there was so severe infection.
On the 8th of May, the team arrived in Arugat, and the hospital was finally ready to treat its first patients.
The idea is to work in collaboration with the Ministry of Health facility. They'll provide consultations and will admit patients with severe conditions.
Even though the hospital's catchment area is fairly vast, casualties directly related to the earthquake are not what MSF sees most.
The military evacuated lots of injured people by helicopter during the first few days. There aren't many casualties now, well, not in Arugat and the villages that the outreach program has visited. So we're going to quickly shift to more general hospital activities. Surgical services, of course, but also maternity care, and we'll probably have pediatric cases. We'll wait to see how it goes over the next few days and weeks before deciding.
In addition to their healthcare needs, thousands of people in remote mountain villages still don't have a roof over their heads. Planning ahead for the monsoon season, MSF teams are preparing to distribute essential items by helicopter.